Right. I'll see you later. Babe, you need a check?
On my way. How's it feel to be back, boss?
Like I never left, honey. Bartender, can I get the mineral water with a twist?
I think you're gonna need something stronger than that.
Dr. Quartermain.
Yeah.
We got the call about John. How is he?
He's being prepped for surgery right now. I'm on my way to OR.
Tell us what happened.
Well, he went into atrial fibrillation and didn't respond to medication. That caused the blood to pool and threw a clot into the carotid artery.
He's had a stroke?
Well, he's showing symptoms of a stroke. Weakness, numbness on one side of his body, and his speech is slurred. We want to get in and remove that clot right now so we can avoid neurological damage.
How bad is it?
We don't know yet.
Monica.
What are his chances of making it through the surgery?
Heart rhythm is still abnormal, which makes the operation risky. But we have no choice. We've got to remove that clot. It is not the best of circumstances, but then again, I have the best team.
Then we better not hold you up any longer.
I know how stressful this is for you. My office is down the hall. It's private, and it would be a good place to wait.
Thanks.
Okay.
Last night, he laughed at me and said he had no intention of dying in hospital.
He's not gonna die.
You're right. This woman's a treasure.
Enough.
Come on, let's take Monica up on her offer.
Privacy will give me too much time to think. I'll stay where there's plenty of traffic.
Oh, why don't we go and sit over there?
I'm gonna make a phone call. I'll be right there.
Okay.
It makes total sense. You didn't tell me about her because you always loved her. And you never got over her. And now she's back in your life, and she's alive. Jax, don't make me ask you again if you still love her. Can I make a call? Yourself.
Oh. Hey, Ruby, what brings you over to this part of town?
You!
Can I get you some coffee, soda, pretzels?
I want some answers.
Well, I'll be happy to oblige.
What's the question? Ruby, welcome to Luke's. Yes, really nice to see you. You wouldn't believe this, but I've been dreaming about a slice of your homemade pumpkin pie. Now, I know our cuisine here doesn't come up to Kelly's standards, but whatever you have tonight, Ruby, it's on the house. So listen, why don't you let me just take you to a nice, quiet little table and...
I'm through being quiet.
I see a thirsty customer over here. Excuse me.
What's it gonna take to get you to back off?
I guess this has something to do with the interrupted wedding.
Brenda.
All I did was make information public that should have been out a long time ago. My intentions were good. I'm not gonna even get into that because I know that, you know, you won't buy it.
You got that right.
Okay, well, what I did was to help Brenda out. And as far as the rest, I am out of her life from now on for good.
Prove it.
I got it. Luke's.
It's me. Is Ruby there? They told me over at Kelly's that she was over there.
Yeah, she's here. It's for you, Brenda.
Hi, honey. What's happening?
I'm at GH, and John is, he's had a relapse, and he's in surgery right now.
I'll be right over. You let Brenda be happy. Now, would you call me a cab?
Yeah, sure. Hey, Mike. Do me a favor, take Ruby home wherever she wants to go. I'll cover for you.
Sure thing.
Thank you there. If that's okay with you there, Ruby. All right. How long you been here?
I came in back and saw Ruby chewing you out, so I decided to wait. Every time I go to kill her, she makes a crack about how terrible it is that I work for you, so I thought I'd save you getting yelled at for that, too.
Well, I appreciate that. Game?
Sure. You break.
How'd it go?
They want a meeting tomorrow night.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where?
Your choice. I thought we could use the warehouse.
No. Place is free. This is just a preliminary conversation. Set something up at the No Name at 10 o'clock.
Okay.
Ooh. So what'd you think?
About the deal?
Yeah.
It could be good. It'll boost your revenues for the whole border area.
The people?
I don't think they'll do anything. And they want to make money, not get you angry.
I want you there.
I'll be there.
At the table. Hell, you know, your math is better than mine, and you know how to read people.
Yeah, but not like you.
Yeah, well, I know how to figure out people's motives, but, you're the first person I've ever seen who, can tell if a person is lying straight out. That's invaluable.
Thank you.
You hear from Robin?
Yeah, she got an A on her history test this afternoon.
Oh, big surprise.
Yeah, big surprise. I could tell me I get a B or something so I could at least cheer her up, you know?
She mentioned Brenda?
Yeah, she said Brenda was pretty upset about Jax's dead wife showing up.
Robin knows I did it.
Yeah.
She must be pretty disappointed in me.
I don't think so. Brenda told her it was just payback for wearing the wire. Now, I said that you were going after Jax because he deserved it. It wasn't your fault he had a wife he dumped.
You didn't say anything about the guy Jax had jump me?
I don't want Robin to worry anymore. Anyway, the only thing she said was she thought you shouldn't have brought her to the wedding. The dead wife.
Yeah, I guess, except... When I first saw Miranda, the first thing I thought about was Lily. She died because of me, and I gotta carry that. And I always will. But this guy, Jax, he hurts this girl, almost kills her, and he walks away like nothing happened. He shows up here, the answer to all, you know, to Brenda's prayers, and everybody breathes a sigh of relief because now she is saved from Big Bad Sonny. But let me tell you something. She... Maybe, you know, she's better off without me. But Jax is no improvement. In fact, he's a lot worse.
Yeah, he hurt his wife and never paid for it.
He took no responsibility. Jason, you kill someone, you maim someone, you're supposed to acknowledge that. Not pretend it never happened. You should have seen him there like God's gift with a house full of people to dance at his wedding. And Brenda on his side. And next to me is the woman whose life he wrecked. Too bad about Brenda. But it felt good to make Jax pay. Looks like you won.
Looks like you did. I'll set the meeting for tomorrow. See ya.
Dr. Ralston, please call extension 5732. Dr. Ralston, please call extension
5732. Thank you so much for coming.
Of course I came.
So scared. Nothing's going the way it's supposed to.
Honey, we're gonna get you through.
I gave Ruby a lift over here. Is there anything I can do?
Yeah, I'm, st-
kind of trying to hold myself together right now. Jax and his mom went to go get some coffee, but they're going to be right back. I really want to be strong for them.
They're family.
Yeah, I know they're family, but so is this woman, Miranda. And I just feel like every time they look at me lately, they're thinking of her. His other wife.
I've been thinking about you a lot. And how tough all this must be.
Yeah. Miss Lois. And Robin. Jack's been my best friend for a while now, but he's going through so much, I can't really expect him to take care of me.
Come on, honey, sit down.
No, I don't think I should sit down right now because I'm afraid I'm just going to lose it, and this is just not the right time. This is really serious. Jax's father might die right now in this surgery.
Hey, why don't you go for a little walk with Ruby and myself, and that way you can just let yourself go in private, and no one will know.
Would you like to do that, Anne?
Oh, I'd love to do that. I can't, though. You know, I have to wait here at least until they get back because they might come over and give us some news on John and... Oh, here they are. Hi.
Hey. Ruby, thanks for coming. Ruby, have you met
at the wedding. Ruby, Mike.
I'm sorry about your husband.
Any word yet?
Not unless you...
No, no one's come from the OR and said anything to me.
Listen, we'd like to take Brenda for a little walk, if you could spare her.
Well, I can't, but I will.
Go ahead, we shouldn't hear anything for a while.
Okay, I won't be very long.
She's a brave one, bless her. I hope you're telling her what she needs to hear.
I hope so, too.
Miranda shouldn't have come. I know that man Corinthus misled her, but still, to jump on an airplane with a perfect stranger without saying a word to John. For all she's been through, the girl's as reckless as ever.
Mom, please don't.
I wouldn't if I were myself. But given the circumstances, I'm inclined to speak my mind. Forgive me, but we never felt she was a match for you.
You never knew her.
We knew enough.
Do you want to know what I felt?
I know how much you cared for her.
I don't think you do. I love Miranda more than anyone or anything in my entire life. She was everything to me.
Table for one?
No, thanks. I'm not staying.
I believe the lady's looking for me. Hello, Miranda.
I came here for the suitcase I left in your car and my passport.
Oh, yeah.
Like I said, I'm not staying.
Well, for people who want passports, this is the best seat in the house.
And I suppose I should be grateful. But it's only a chair.
Have a seat. How's it going with your husband?
You're unbelievable. You've turned people's lives upside down. People that I love are suffering. I don't want to sit here and chit-chat with you. I don't like what you did, and I don't like you. Just in case you have any doubts.
I don't believe this. You think I'm the bad guy in all this?
Well, let's think about it. If you hadn't convinced me to come here, Jax and his bride would be retaking their vows, and John wouldn't be fighting for his life.
And Jax would still have a very much alive wife who he thought was dead. His dad would be lying to him, and Brenda, he would be...
And none of it would be any of your damn business. So don't pull any lectures on me about the beauty of truth. Because you and I both know that your motives in this are strictly self-serving.
I didn't create your trouble.
You know what? I've had about all I can take from you. No, listen, your passport.
You have to admit, it makes a certain kind of sense.
Go ahead. Waste my time.
I'm going to tell you how I see my partner, so you pay attention. I stopped a fake wedding Some caviar went bad. A few hundred flowers wilted. Some guy, people got dressed up for nothing. That's no, it's no big deal in the scheme of things.
Tell that to John Jax if he survives.
Oh, I didn't... I did not cause John Jack's heart attack. The man collapsed because he'd been conning his son for years and got caught. He was living in a big lie and involving a lot of other people in it. Now, his lie came out. Your lie came out. Hey, I'm just a walk-on in this drama.
Don't be so modest. You know, because in my version, you got a leading role. Iago ain't got nothing on you. Must be some kind of power trip you're on, huh? Knowing that you're manipulating all of us? I mean, if it hadn't been for you, I'd be on the other side of the world all alone. And Jax and Brenda would be on their second honeymoon.
Correction. Second pass at bigamy. The man's still married to you, even though he didn't think so. But you and Daddy Jax did. I may have shined a light on the lie, but I did not create the situation. You did.
You know, I always knew where I stood with my father. He never had any use for me. But he didn't even try to hide it. With Jax, it's different. He trusted his father so much. You know, it's just killing him to find out that this man that he idolized his whole entire life has been lying to him this whole time. I'm so afraid that if him and Jax don't resolve this before John dies, if John dies, that Jax is just going to be different. You know I love Jax. I didn't even realize it till I was standing there in my wedding dress getting ready to walk down the aisle with him. It felt so good. And the whole entire time we've been together, I'd never said those three words to him. So, you know, I went over to his room because I wanted to tell him before we went downstairs together. I knocked on the door and I told him that I loved him. I do. I'm so afraid that nothing's ever going to be the same again. That nothing's ever going to be right again. And I am so mad at him. I am so mad at him because I trusted him. He made me trust him because he was always so wonderful to me. He was always so open and honest with me. And he was just my best friend in the world. He is my best friend in the world. And I don't know. I don't know how to deal with this. I don't know how I'm supposed to act or what I'm supposed to feel.
Just the way you're feeling now.
Yeah. Do you know what John said to me when I was in ICU with him? He told me to fight for Jax. What do you think that means, Mike? I mean, why would I have to fight for him? He's my husband. Do you think that he meant that Jax is still in love with her? Or that Jax would leave me for her? I mean, that's crazy. Jax would never do that. What if I lose him?
His surgery went well. He responded to the medication, and we've got his heart back in a normal sinus rhythm. We removed the embolus.
That's the blood clot.
Yes, just in time. It was external, hadn't traveled into the brain tissue. So we reestablished circulation to the area.
Can we see him?
No visitors in recovery. Look, I suggest that you all go home and get some rest, and by the time you come back, he'll probably be in his room.
Well, I guess a little rest isn't a bad idea. Don't want to frighten the poor bloke out of his wits when he opens his eyes. Why don't you two come along and take a little time for yourselves?
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Tell me, Corinthos. Do you just go around the world finding situations like mine and forcing people to own up to them? I mean, how long exactly have you had this goddamn
call? Did I force you to get on that plane?
You broke into my world and you used me. And you set it up quite nicely, didn't you? You knew exactly what you were doing. My secret was out. And you were going to tell Jax that I was alive, unless I wanted the opportunity to do it myself. Without a word about his romance or his new marriage. If I would have known that, I would have written, I would have phoned, I would have done anything but just show up in Port Charles.
Oh, I guess I really screwed up this time. I mean, you never wanted to lay eyes on him, and I tricked you into it. Wow.
My coming here has hurt a lot of people. Don't you care about that?
People were getting hurt before you showed up, Miranda, including you. Now, you know, maybe one of these days you're gonna decide that what I did was a favor, and you're gonna throw me a big party. It'd be interesting if it worked out that way.
What were we in the middle of when the phone call came from the hospital?
I was asking you a question.
Right. And as I recall, you wondered what my feelings were for Miranda now. Okay. I'll try to be as coherent about this as I can.
Let's not talk about this right now.
Well, forgive me if I don't fall all over myself, thanking you.
Well, just remember one thing, Miranda. I did not lie to you.
If it suits your purposes to think that.
The whole Jax clan lied to Brenda, and they would have kept on lying as long as they could get away with it. Now she knows.
I don't think I've ever met anybody quite so transparent. Tell me that you didn't do all of this, just so you could have Brenda for yourself.
Tell me you didn't come here hoping to pick up where you left off with Jack.